we're learning more every day about how COVID impacts human health.
It's more serious than the flu, that's for sure.
The level of contagiousness combined with the fact that individuals who are asymptomatic can spread the disease makes it very difficult to grapple with.
The other coronaviruses typically only evoke upper respiratory mild infections. These RNA particles that get into your cells produce many, many different proteins that are able to interact with a lot of our bodily reactions.
It really looks like you have a pneumonia. It's almost hard for a non-medical person to distinguish this from a normal pneumonia.
It's for sure a virus that primarily attacks the respiratory system. It attaches to a receptor that is present on many of our cells, in particular in the respiratory cells. Your immune system starts reacting, and in many patients, actually goes into this hyperinflammatory state. Some of the inflammatory reactions that affect the whole body also affect the brain. It is known that the virus is able to bind to the cells that line the inside of your vascular system. The brain appears to be one of the organs where this hypercoagulable state occurs in patients with SARS-CoV-2. So we see a lot of more stroke in the brain. The incidence of neurological problems associated to SARS-CoV-2 is not much higher than what we can see in another serious infectious situation or disorder. But the scale of the pandemic is so high that we are approaching hundreds and hundreds of thousands neurological problems worldwide. Some people may also have, as we call it, anosmia or dysgeusia, a loss of taste and smell. The fact is that this loss of smell might even be a very useful symptom, because in many patients it's an early symptom. The cells that line your nose on the inside do contain the receptor for the virus, so certainly these cells can be seriously infected with the virus, and most likely that is one of the mechanisms of action of the disturbed smell. It is unclear whether the virus takes that pathway to truly also invade your nervous system. So 50% of patients tend to complain indeed for a long time about these smell and taste problems, about concentration problems, cognitive problems. Patients tend to complain for weeks to months of general tiredness. Your immune system has been working really hard.
So lots of long COVID syndrome cases are emerging, and we don't fully understand kind of how long it will impact someone and their well-being.